Production, trafficking and sale of illicit drugs remains the largest and most harmful criminal problem in Europe today, destroying hundreds of thousands of lives every year within our communities. And it's a criminal sector that is going through a profound change powered by technology and the role that this darknet plays in particular. So the traditional image of drug pushers running their illicit operations from the darkest corners of every town and city in Europe is quickly changing, quickly being replaced by a much more hidden, much less visible online version of illicit trading of drugs. And indeed, at an industrial scale, the darknet marketplaces that Europol is helping to investigate with its law enforcement partners around Europe and indeed around the world are trading in hundreds of thousands of different forms of illicit drugs every day, huge quantities, generating huge quantities of illicit profits. So the impact is clear, the scale of it is large enough to harm many, many of our citizens. But more importantly, I think, it's the way in which the darknet plays a role to change the way in which this criminal sector is operating, making it, as I said, much easier for criminals to hide their identity and to hide their criminal activity. The anonymity offered online, the ever more sophisticated levels of encryption technology that are being abused by criminals in the darknet are moving this very significant criminal problem of our society, moving it more and more underground, and therefore giving law enforcement new challenges of a type we haven't seen before, to work to identify those that are mostly responsible for propping up this trade and therefore to protect our citizens from the harm that it causes. But as the Commissioner said, the police are doing some good work in response as well. And in the summer of this year, indeed, Europol helped to coordinate with the FBI, the Dutch police, and many other authorities around Europe, the single most important operation yet against marketplaces on the darknet, the combined taking down of the marketplaces of Alphabet and Hansa, which between them were offering 350,000 different illicit commodities for sale, over 60% of which were drugs. It shows that when the police community can operate together across borders in innovative ways, we can still be successful in this modern technological age, still be successful in fighting back against criminal organizations to protect our people. It relies on effective cooperation between different agencies, but it also relies on our understanding better the dimensions of this problem, which is going through a profound change in ways that we need to track very carefully. And that's why this report today, jointly produced by EMCDDA and Europol, is so important, because it's the most authoritative assessment yet that we've found and we've produced based on excellent research, not least by the people of this agency here in Lisbon, that have provided a unique perspective on why this dimension of the illicit drugs problem in Europe is now very significant and it needs to be combated in a concerted way in the European Union. I pay tribute, therefore, to the collaboration that my colleagues at Europol and Alexis' colleagues here at EMCDDA have, the work that they have done to produce this fine report, and I encourage everyone to read it for what it tells us.